career?
Or just in your life?
Oh, well, plenty of times, unfortunately. I've been in a few street fights, for sure. And not, I didn't start them. Are you recording this?
Welcome back to It's Recording Time Media. Well, it did not go exactly as planned with what I wanted to do with Johnny, but it's like, you know, things happen for a reason, recorders. Let's just say, like, I had to, you know, do this interview while I was still at work. Like, don't worry, I was able to go on my break so I could have done the thing. But the thing is, it's like, leading up to it, I felt like I was almost gonna, miss my time slot because how, like, let's just say there's this printer that I use at work that it's essential that I use. That way my manager knows that I'm actually doing my job. Out of all the days, the damn thing stopped working. Like, it wouldn't print well. So I had to go get one of the other managers to inspect the thing, and the whole thing took 30 minutes, and I thought, was I gonna miss my time slot? Does God, like, hate me or what? But with all doing this, we managed to find a way to work around it, so I quickly snuck away from work, took off my uniform, did the interview, which, first of all, I want to give a shout out to my co-worker, Jamie, for being understanding. Like, thank you, Jamie. But in all doing this, because of how I ended up shooting this thing, I have to make some tweaks to it. So it's not going to be like the typical videos that you're expecting. So let's get to it. One, two, three. It's recording time! Johnny, welcome back to the channel. Always a pleasure to have you. Anyway, let's get right to it. Tell us about you taking over Broly. Because I actually talked to Vic Mignotta not too long ago. And he said that it was a Funimation's doing. Care to elaborate on that?
Right. Well, same. My answer is the same. It was Funimation's doing. I don't know all the details of what went down with him and all that stuff, you know. All I know is I was contacted actually through Toei Animation in Japan. I know some people there because I've worked for them on different projects and things like that. So I know some people there. And they had contacted me and asked if I would be interested in voicing Broly in the future. And I was like, and I didn't know what that meant. I didn't know if I was replacing him or if it was a new iteration of it or something new. And I was like, I'd be interested, but I thought that was Vic's thing, you know? And then I found out there's a lot of things, a lot more going on behind the scenes that I just wasn't privy to. And so it was one of those things where, you know, I was like, well, I guess I got to talk to Vic about this and see what's going on there. You know, yeah. So
thank you for finally clearing that up for us. Next question. Are you still involved in the Legend of the White Dragon project? Because you've been very quiet on social media during the quarantine.
Unfortunately, I am not. I was part owner in it, but then they changed the contracts and it got a little weird and messy. And so I was like, no longer have me part of it. So
yeah. Thanks for telling us that, Johnny. Now tell us about your own project that you're working on.
Yeah, well, actually, I was supposed to be doing a film with Jason Frank, but he, like a week before shooting, he left. He quit, and he took money out of it and then just kind of bailed. And that's where things kind of went sour. And so I had to just shoot something else. And so I came up with a completely different storyline with a little sci-fi project on the spot and rewrote it with some friends in like a couple days and then just shot a whole different film. But I'll be releasing it like October, like on Halloween, I believe. I'm going to upload it online so people can watch it. No crowdfunding. It's just a free thing just to say thanks to the fans and hopefully people can enjoy it. You know?
I'm looking forward to it, Johnny. And speaking of movies, you were in My Hero Academia this year. Tell us about how you got the part of Nine because I really loved your performance.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, I was sent an email that said that they wanted me to audition for Nine. And so they had me audition for a couple other characters in the past as well. I don't recall which characters they were. But then I got another audition and, you know, anytime Funimation asks, hey, will you please audition for this? I'm like, yeah, sure. If I am around. And so I auditioned and they wanted me to adjust what I was doing, make them a little darker. And I was like, okay, sure. And then they did that. And it just kind of fell together and finally got to see it and work on it. And it was actually really fun. It's super cool.
Yeah. It's like, I was so impressed. I was thinking, what if he just came back to Power Rangers as a villain, like a voiceover role instead of like, you know, physically being there, just come back as a villain.
That would be fun, Steven. Hey man, thanks for coming by.
Well, thank you for your time, Johnny, and we are out, recorders. Sorry I had to go this way, but here's a teaser. Here's the version that you will never ever see.
Hey Johnny, how you doing? Please ignore my whereabouts.
Why, where are you?
I am outside of my actual job, so I had to like schedule this while I'm on my break.
All right.
Anyway, thank you for your time for tuning in, recorders. Be sure to hit that subscribe button, comment down below, give us a like, and catch you next time.